So why are we talking about prescription digital therapeutics? And quite frankly, I feel like I open up every journal these days and there's some review of, hey, digital therapeutics are here, they're changing the world, and you know, we need to be harnessing these technologies. And I realized I didn't really know, is that true? What do we know about these things? So it deserved a deep dive, and that's what we're going to try and present to you today. So first of all, just putting into context where prescription digital therapeutics place is amongst the digital health realm. People are talking about digital health adding and benefiting medicine everywhere. But digital health is really broad. It's pretty much everything that we've digitized to improve healthcare. Versus digital medicine is the stuff that, you know, kind of just supports medical practice. Software as a medical device does not have to be a therapeutic. It could be something that's diagnostic in nature. But because digital therapeutics are software as a medical device, they often fall under that category. So we're going to be talking about software as a medical device as a digital therapeutic that have been cleared by the FDA. And the ones you see on the screen are actually the ones that have already been approved by the FDA for prescription therapeutics in psychiatry or in mental health disorders. And we're going to talk about several of these today. Now, what you need to know about these therapeutics is that they can be standalone therapeutics that deliver cognitive behavioral therapy modules. And actually, this is improving over time as our AI capabilities improve over time. But essentially, what they've done is digitize what would be traditional cognitive behavioral therapy sessions and put them into modules. You can have things like a sleep cycle tracker that provide us feedback and help the patient understand what behaviors that they have prior to sleep lead to better sleep when they're going through the night. Or things like mood diaries that could also help them understand cause and effect through that app. But more often, what we're seeing being approved are these combination therapies where they're providing these kinds of supportive services together with traditional pharmacotherapy.